How do you earn more income in 2024? I want to share with you the fastest way to do this. That is to create a skill set that can help you get to the next level. I've actually got 7 things I want to share with you today that can really help you get there. So first one, if you're able to upskill yourself and you're able to take yourself to the next level, the skill sets using things like artificial intelligence, using something that can really add value to a business and you get paid to do that, is one of the fastest ways that you can monetize. What are some of the skill sets that people are really looking for right now? Easiest ones is marketing. If you're able to market for somebody and generate leads for them, you're now able to help that person make more money, especially in their business. For me, I always think about different ways to not just monetize, but to help other people monetize. You can make more money by helping other people make money. I see too many people wanting to kind of start their own thing, trying to do things in a way that doesn't get massive results for other people. And that's why you're not earning the income you want to earn. For me, it's always like, what skill sets can you acquire? For example, one of them, learning how to code a blockchain, crypto. Is quite a big thing that's happening. More and more people are now adopting it. And in fact, it's becoming mainstream now. I literally drove past ATM that says you can withdraw cryptocurrency. And you have credit cards like Sprint now, where it becomes a virtual credit card or a virtual debit card that sits on your phone as like your Apple Pay. And then what happens is you're now able to start paying for things on that. So it's bridging that gap, knowing what skill sets to use and knowing how to improve that can really help you. The second way is sales. When I started as a business owner and an entrepreneur, one thing I had to get really, really good at is learning how to sell. And some people, they have a lot of things against selling. It's not about selling, it's all about serving. I have a lot of friends who literally close sales for people and they get paid 10 to 20% commission. And they're selling things for $5,000, $10,000, $20,000. Can you imagine if they sell something for $10,000, they're getting paid between $1,000 to $2,000 just for making a phone call. That's one skill set that you can really help take to the next level. And third one, which I think is really important for skill set, is making sure that you're able to connect to the right people. So what sort of connections can you make where you can make an introduction? A lot of the times people were coming to me and saying, John, who do you know who can help me do X? I would actually find people who I could really connect with, and I would see what they wanted and what they didn't want, and I would see who could actually provide that solution. Because a lot of the time when people come to me and they say, John, do you know anyone who knows how to source property below its market value? I know a lot of those people. And so when I connect them with the investors now are able to make money. So that's why they say your network equals your net worth. Get really, really good at skill set and you'll increase your income. The second one is having more contacts. You heard me say this before, it's not who you know, but it's who knows you. You need to start writing down a list of all the people who you know, who have got high value that need something. And it doesn't matter how rich you are, how much money you have, people always need help with stuff. It could be a situation where people need to find more finance. Again, if you look at the first one of skill set, people connect the right people. Depending on how much money they're raising, they're taking 5% of the funds that they raise. You don't even have to have money, you just need to know the people who have the money, and now you're able to have these people create these things for you as well, and that's where you get paid in introduction. And sometimes hanging around the right people, you get different mindsets. For example, I was never really into the whole Web3 space, and people ask me, John, like, have you invested in any of the Web3 stuff, the crypto stuff? And the answer is yes, of course. In fact, one of the platforms that I invested in is now $1 billion in valuation. I do get into that because they say that when everyone is digging for gold, then you need to find all the people that want to buy the spades. Whenever we're talking about the contacts, sometimes it's hanging around the right people. A friend of mine recently told me, he said, John, do you know that there's something you can put your money into, what we call decentralized finance? I didn't believe him at first, but the interest rate was insane. I never even knew it existed. So I tested it, and it makes enough money now to be able to pay for things. If you want to pay for things when you're out, you want to pay for a dinner, you want to pay for your petrol, you want to pay for your car, you want to pay for a house, you can put your money into things that can also have a high interest rate. And that's why hanging around the right people will give you that sort of knowledge and those sort of expertise. The third one is offering services. I remember when I first started off as an entrepreneur, the first business service that I would actually offer is a deal closing service. So I'd find people who wanted to be able to close the deals, and I would say to them, hey, you know what? If you want this property deal, I'm going to close it for you, and I take 1% of the finder's fee. So fastest way to start a business is actually to create some form of service-based business. For example, I mentioned in the past talking about artificial intelligence. One thing that you really got to all get clued up on is artificial intelligence. You now have something which is called the GPT IT store, which is like the app store. And that now means that you're able to start creating your own apps, your own AI. You don't need any programming skills. You need to train the AI in the right way. A lot of people ask me, John, how do I earn more income? How do I start a business? How do I invest in real estate? So what I've done now is I've taken my knowledge and I've put that into an artificial intelligence. It'll be able to answer questions how I answer it. It'll be able to answer questions and have what we call generative AI as well. You could actually build this. In fact, I actually got an email from ChatGPT and they said, would you like us to include your AI on our GPT store? It's kind of like how app developers are creating apps for things like Uber and things like that, but you can now create your own AI app, which can help people do things. For example, if you're good at finances, for example, you could create an AI that can help people save money. And then people can go to that GPT store and they can actually download or ask questions on how do you save more money? How do you make more money? How do you multiply more money? So you can do things like that. You could create a GPT for marketing, and the goal is to keep training it up. And here's the thing, it's like creating a mini search engine, which is specified for a specific outcome. And if you're able to do that, you can then provide a service for that and then charge a fee for it, or even better, sell it. I'm telling you, this year, a lot of people are gonna be creating a lot of AI that can help people sell a lot of these products and services, which will really help you get to that next level. And that's one thing I think is really, really powerful. Another thing that I think is really good is making sure that we're all creating different ways to be able to start helping other people do things. It's about finding out what people's problems are, creating a solution. That's where the GPT store comes in. The GPT store will help you create that solution for somebody else, which will help them get to that next level. That works really well. This is a big one. Number four is value add. The more value that you can add to somebody's life, the more income you make, period. For example, I have a friend who's going through a lot of legal issues right now. Do I know any good lawyers? The answer is yes, I do. Could I put that person in touch with that person as well? The answer is yes. Could I get paid for a referral for adding value? I could add the value first and then get paid a referral for it. For example, fitness. A lot of people want to get into shape. A lot of people doing biohacking now. A lot of people are in a position where they want to get to a point where they can really serve other people, but they don't really know how to package that up. So the key is to actually package your knowledge, your skills, expertise. It's actually one of the things that we teach in a lot of our events. If any of you are watching this, you need more help, check out the link in the description. We actually have a lot of events that come up that can help you do this as well. If I come back to real estate, one thing I used to do a lot is I used to always find people that had property deals and I would say to them, let me negotiate the deal for you. When I would negotiate the deal, you know what happened? I would get paid a closing fee for it. So anything between 1% and 3% of closing that deal. In fact, there's a lot of developers right now that were looking to offload a lot of properties. I have a friend in Singapore who takes a lot of people, they fly them over from Singapore and they all visit these new developments and they sell them on, they get paid a commission. So that's another thing you could do as well, is again, adding value. The question you got to ask yourself, if you want to earn more, if you want to make more, where can you add more value? The more value you add, the more income you can help that person grow to that next level. Number five, prove before you charge. So this is one thing that I used to do a lot when it came to real estate. I used to negotiate people's deals and I would call them and say, hey, I just negotiated 20% off your deal. Would you like to do a joint venture? This is how I'd actually be able to pick up a lot of property deals. If any of you are looking to buy property, now is probably the time to start looking and shopping. I've built a multi-million pound property portfolio. How? By finding properties below its market value. So there's actually three rules that I use. Make money when you buy, not when you sell. Use OPM, which stands for other people's money. And the third one is make sure you have multiple exit strategies. If you can't rent it, can you sell it? If you can't sell it, can you rent it? If you can rent it, can you do a HMO? If you can't do a HMO, stands for houses of multiple occupation. You might want to get to a position where people, they kind of say, well, John, how do I get even started in this? This is why if you focus on proving the steps first before you do it, that's another way you can start earning income. For example, you can now use AI to build a website, right? So if you go to Hostinger and lots of websites like this, where you can say, build me a website that looks like a Shopify store, and it will build it for you using AI. You can then go back to somebody else and say, look, I added value. I think this would be great for you. Why don't you use it and then pay me a fee for it? There's a lot of influencers right now who are broke. Influencers, they have a lot of followers. They have a massive social media engagement, but they don't make any money. So here's a good strategy for you. Find the influencers, create one of these websites for them, create a product that can sell, and you get them to send it out to all their followers. And now when they buy, all you do is you can charge a flat fee to do it, or you would take a percentage of every single sale that comes through that. So that's another way that you can start monetizing as well. Adding value is actually one of the best ways to start increasing your income. Number six, more multiplying of income. There are three types of income. income. You've heard me say this before in a lot of my events, a lot of my shows. Active income, where we trade time for money. So you gotta ask yourself how much money you're getting paid per hour. That is time for money. Number two is passive income. What can you build or create that creates income? For example, I know a lot of people now who are buying supercars and they are renting them out for £1,000 a day. You could actually turn a liability into an asset. That's one strategy you could use. I know a lot of my friends who are doing that right now. They're buying Lamborghinis, Ferraris, and they, of course, they get the right insurance, and then they create a whole business from it. I know people who buy a lot of supercars that are liabilities and then start a supercar club and charge people $10,000 per membership. And if they have 100 members, you can buy a lot of supercars with that. Just kind of get you to think out of the box, because I think a lot of people, they're very tunnel vision. It's like, one, we want to be funnel vision. We want to see all the different options, which is why if you're finding my videos useful, please do me a favor and share this with people who are really struggling. If they want to earn more, if they want to achieve more, if they're looking for some motivation to really get to the next level, I just really want that for my community that really can help grow to that next level as well. Number six is making sure you find more ways to multiply. For example, you have decentralized finance. If you don't know what that is, basically like a very high interest rate. If you look at the bank right now, they're giving you not a very high interest rate. But what if I said that you could get a massive interest rate? But you got to do your research first, right? You got to learn before you. And that's why I have these events where a lot of my friends who teach me this stuff, I bring them onto the events, my virtual events, to teach all of you the right way to do it. Don't just do things half-heartedly. Get the right knowledge. You must learn before you earn. If you write the word learn down, L-E-A-R-N, you take off the L, what does it spell? It spells earn. You must always learn before you earn. That's a really powerful thing that you must always think about. Different ways to multiply it. In fact, one way to do this as well, and I don't know if any of you are up for this, but if you've got money sitting in the bank right now, there are a lot of people who are looking for high interest savings, or they are looking to loan it out at high interest as well. For example, when I first started in business, I was taking a lot of bridging loans out to buy property. Because here's the thing, right? If you want to buy a property, you're not always going to have your own money to do it, but somebody's got the money. So what they do is they lend me the money. I pay them 1% of the money that I borrow. And then once I bought that property, I can sell it or I can refinance it, and then I pay them back. That's another strategy that, you know, a lot of you may want to start incorporating, start using as well. For me, it's really looking at different ways you can multiply your money. So if you've got money right now, you might want to look at lending out. Of course, you need to have all your securities in place to make sure your agreements, your loan agreements and things like that, but also check with your financial planner as a professional first before you do it. They always say that you should never lend our friends and family money, we should gift it, because if you lend it, it comes as a loan, it can destroy a relationship. And I'm sure a lot of you can also relate to that as well. Number seven is really looking at what we call multiple income streams. Right now, if you're watching me, you probably maybe have one, two, maybe three income streams. You need to figure out different ways of creating income streams. For example, one of the ways I create an additional form of income, I have my own business. My business makes its own money, and that's great. But I can only be in charge of one business. But what if I consult another business? And I say, I'll teach you how to double your income, how to increase your sales, how to generate more leads. All I want in exchange is 20%. This is what we call a sweat equity play, where you can actually give advice to people for their businesses. In fact, one of my students in Singapore is doing this with another company. He literally took my strategy that I shared with him. He's now working with a digital agency to teach him how to get more clients. And based on that, he then gets paid a commission from that as well. That's another way you can monetize by increasing an income stream. Real estate is another good one. I recommend all of you start buying real estate. I buy property all around the UK and in central London, zone one. And people say to me, John, you can't get good deals in London in zone one. Trust me, you can. You can buy properties 20 to 30% below its market value. And as we go through my YouTube channel, I'll create more and more content on this as well. If any of you are interested in more real estate stuff, just comment below the word real estate. And if I see enough people wanting to learn more about property, then I can create more videos, maybe take you around some of my properties around the UK as well to show you some of the things that I've been able to do and achieve in the last 20 years of being an entrepreneur, investor, and mentor. When you're thinking about different income streams, you must always think about how can you take the income but multiply it through the efforts, not of you, but of other people. If you want to create different income streams, you can't be the person creating the income stream. You've got to have other people create an income stream for you. So for example, you might have really, really good at hiring people. You could assemble a team, drop that team into a company, let them perform, and you take a fee. So that's another way that you could create an income stream. Again, I mentioned real estate. You've got things like stocks and shares as well. So a billionaire friend of mine taught me a strategy. He said, John, if you want to invest in stocks, here's the three things you got to focus on. And he taught me how to get in, how to get out, and how to manage the risk. And again, as we go through this YouTube channel, I'll also be hanging out with some of my friends as well. I'll be interviewing them, some of the things that they've taught me, so you guys can learn this as well. So make sure you subscribe to the channel, turn on bell notifications, and you'll be notified. Also, make sure you like and leave a comment. It just helps the algorithm to really help get to the next level. So these are really some of the things that you really want to focus on. One, have more skills. Two, make more contacts. Three, you want to create what we call a done for you or start with a service-based business. Four, add more value. Five,
lucrative.
Prove the model works so you can change it. Charge for that, like the GPT store. Number six is make sure you're multiplying your income. And number seven is make sure you create multiple streams of income. So if you love this, by the way, do me a favor, like, subscribe, share this with other people who really need the help. What I'll also do, I'll also link some videos here and here as well. And I'll see you then. Bye.